We'll discuss one more parabola. Previously, we are having vertex as 0, 0. Now, shifting of vertex from 0, 0 to alpha, comma, beta. Then comes alpha 0, 0 is shifted to alpha, comma, beta implies x is equal to x plus alpha, y is equal to y plus beta. That means this is nothing but equations of translation. So we require capital X is equal to X minus alpha, capital Y is equal to Y minus beta. So in the standard form of equation, Y square equal to 4AX, if you replace small x, capital Y, capital X, capital Y as this is Y minus beta whole square is equal to 4A into X minus alpha. That means it is nothing but shifting of origin from 0, 0 to alpha, beta. The standard equation y square equal to 4ax is converted to y minus beta whole square is equal to 4a into x minus alpha. Now, let us draw the diagram here. You can see this is coordinate axis and this is going to be the parabola. Now, this is vertex alpha comma beta, whereas origin is 0, 0. Now, let us write all the properties one by one. Now, you observe that vertex is alpha, beta. This is the focus. This is the axis. And somewhere here, directrix will be here. So, we list out one by one all the properties. Here, we have to clearly see the axis of the parabola is parallel to the x-axis. So, first write down all vertex is equal to, previously it is 0, 0. Now it is shifted to alpha, comma, beta. So, new vertex is given by alpha, comma, beta. Then comes focus. Focus is given by, previously it is a, comma, 0. Now increased by alpha, comma, beta. That is a, comma, 0 plus alpha, comma, beta. It is alpha plus a, comma, beta. Then comes length of lattice rectum. Length of lattice rectum, in any case, it is 4a only. Then equation of directrix. Previously, equation of directrix is x plus a is equal to 0. Now it is x plus a is equal to, whenever x term is there, it is increasing by x coordinate of new origin. That is alpha times. Then equation of lattice rectum is given by, in the same fashion, x minus a is equal to alpha. Now we require tangent at vertex. So tangent at vertex is equal to, now you can see that it is parallel to the y-axis. So parallel to y-axis means this is x is equal to 0. This is x is equal to alpha. So x minus alpha is equal to 0. These are the few properties. Even if you want, you can write the ends of lattice rectum like this. Previously, we know that it is a comma 2a, a comma minus 2a. So ends of lattice rectum are a comma 2a plus alpha comma beta and a comma minus 2a plus alpha comma beta. So, in the new origin, this will be like this. Next, if this parabola is rotated by an angle of 180 degrees, then this parabola will be turned like this. That means, it will be like this only. You can see very clearly, parabola will be like this. Now, you observe that axis of the parabola is similarly parallel to the x-axis. So, we'll write all the properties again. Vertex is equal to, will not change, alpha comma beta. This is alpha comma beta. Then comes focus. Previously focus is equal to, it is minus a comma 0 in the previous case. Now it is plus alpha comma beta. This will become alpha minus a comma beta. Then comes length of lattice rectum. Length of lattice rectum will be always equal to 4a units. Then comes equation of directrix. Now, equation of directrix previously it is given by x minus a is equal to 0. Now it is x minus a is equal to alpha. Then comes equation of lattice rectum is given by x plus a is equal to alpha. Then comes tangent at vertex. If you draw tangent at vertex like this, it is parallel to the y-axis. So tangent at vertex is x minus alpha is equal to 0. Now ends of lattice rectum, you can see ends of lattice rectum are given by, this is a, 2a in the previous case. Now ends of lattice rectum is through focus it will go, since it is in third and fourth quadrant. Now you can see very clearly, this is a, 2a is there, reflection will become minus a, 2a plus alpha, beta. Then comes minus a minus 2a plus alpha comma beta. Now the speciality of these two curves is the axis of the parabola is always parallel to the x-axis. Please remember, the axis of the parabola is always parallel to the x-axis.